Hello dear Steemians, Dtubers, members of Uptrend, and all beautiful and creative blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko, Bitcoin is trading at the level of $10,808. Ethereum is trading close to the psychological level of $200. XRP is trading at the level of 27 cents 0.9497. So we see that the prices of the major cryptocurrencies, they have stabilized for the last, let's say, 24 hours after the short rebound that took place a few days ago. So those prices are not bad for the major cryptocurrencies. But today I would like to analyze, to have a look at the price chart of STEEM, of our beloved cryptocurrency, and to analyze the price of STEEM. Because yes, Bitcoin at a level or at levels over $10,000 per one digital coin, this is not a bad level. Ethereum is at good levels. But what about the other alternative coins? That's why today I want to analyze the price chart of STEEM. Of course, again, according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that STEEM is trading at levels lower than the psychological level of 20 cents per one digital coin at the moment. For one STEEM, you will receive on the exchanges on average 17 cents 0.560 or something like this. The price has just changed. So this is actually the price chart of STEEM against the USDT on a 1 day time frame. And unfortunately, we still see that we have this sequence of descending highs. So to some extent, this is a bearish signal. This is one of the prerequisites or requirements in order to say that we're in a downtrend. Of course, the price of STEEM to some extent has been in some kind of consolidation phase, or it has been trading sideways since the beginning of the year. But of course, if we have a look at the price chart, how it looks like in the recent months, we see this sequence of descending high. So this is a clear downtrend. If we have a look at 1 week time frame, unfortunately, on the price chart, we see that we have this sequence of bearish red candlesticks that have descending highs, local highs, and descending local lows. So to some extent, this is an additional bearish signal on this solid 1 week time frame. Of course, I am very curious what will happen in the near future, because if we switch back to 1 day time frame, I will draw some parallel lines. So this is actually some kind of descending channel. So this is this descending channel. What I want to see is the price of STEEM against the USDT is fluctuating within this descending channel. Let me do it like this. So I will remove this line and draw a parallel line. I would like to mention, to outline or to highlight, that at the moment we're testing the lower bound or the lower line of this descending channel. And no doubt, if the price of Bitcoin continues to rebound, and of course, in addition, if the prices of the other major cryptocurrencies, they continue to rebound, or their rebound, probably the price of STEEM will be able to rebound from the lower line of this descending channel as well. So this is some kind of, let's say, support line, and probably in the near future, after fluctuating near this line, we will see some kind of rebound, but it is still not, there is no guarantee, so we have to be really very careful. And what I want to say is that this is still a bearish descending channel. We have to be very careful. And this is what I wanted to comment today about the price of STEEM against USDT. The question is when this bearish trend on the price chart of Steam will finish, will end. In my view, one of the major factors or signals that will be able to put an end, let's say, to put an end to this bearish trend will be if the price chart of Steam against Bitcoin changes. Let me tell you what I mean, because a few times ago I commented on the price chart of Steam again Bitcoin. So this is the price chart again, once again, of Steam against the price of BTC. Let's have a look at the price chart of Steam against BTC. I would like to mention that this is the price chart of Steam against BTC. Unfortunately, if we have a look at the price chart on 1 week time frame, we see once again this sequence of the bearish candlesticks that have descending highs and descending lows. In my view, the price of Steam against the US dollar will stabilize and will put an end, let's say, will put an end to the bear downtrend once the price chart of Steam against BTC stops to fall. So if we see some formation of candlesticks, that will put an end to this sequence of bearish candlesticks with descending highs and descending lows, then probably the situation will change. This is my point of view. That's why I would like to mention once again that I will closely keep an eye on the price chart of Steam against BTC, in addition to the price chart of Steam against US dollar, in order to catch to the signals if the bear market on Steam or in Steam ecosystem ends. That's it for today about the price analysis of Steam. Now I just want to mention some interesting news relating to the cryptocurrency world, and that's why let's switch to the news that I want to comment on. I found, I read an interview with Vitalik Buterin. We know that he is one of the greatest person in the cryptocurrency world. He is the creator of Ethereum. So he talked about the cryptocurrency world, about some important issues that the cryptocurrency world has faced recently. So I will include a link to this interview so you will be able to have a look at it. It's really very interesting to read. But what I want to say is one of the most important questions nowadays in the cryptocurrency world is, what are the roadblocks to more widespread adoption of cryptocurrencies? So people always ask, what should happen? What should happen in order to see a wider adoption of cryptocurrencies that will, at the end of the day, drive the prices of the cryptocurrencies, and they will skyrocket, so it will be a driver to price increase. Of course, as I have mentioned and talk a lot about this topic, in my view, this is the scalability issue, and this is what Vitalik Buterin said as well. Scalability is a big bottleneck because of the Ethereum blockchain is almost full. If you're a bigger organization, the calculus is that if we join, it will not only be more full, but we will be competing with everyone from transaction space. It is already expensive, and it will be even 5 times more expensive because of us. There is pressure keeping people from joining, but improvements in scalability can do a lot in improving that. So this is the greatest problem at the moment, the scalability issue. Once the scalability issue in the cryptocurrency world is solved, then the mass adoption will increase, and at the end of the day, it will trigger the solid price increase of the prices of the major cryptocurrencies and of the good, let's say, alternative coins. So this is the biggest problem. How do you improve the scalability issue? Was one of the next questions. Vitalik Buterin answered that if we, the main problem with current blockchain is the this idea that every computer has to verify every transaction. If we can move to networks where every computer on average verifies only a small portion of transactions, then it can be done better. But can that be done without sacrificing security? There will be a sacrifice, but it would be fairly modest. So this is really a very nice interview. So the biggest problem at the moment is the scalability issue. Of course, there are some other relatively small issues at the moment. This is privacy, security is of use, let's say, is of use of the cryptocurrencies with these private public keys and etc. But scalability is the greatest problem. And we see that most of the cryptocurrencies, of the major cryptocurrencies, they have faced the scalability issue. And that's why the cryptocurrency market is in, the price of the cryptocurrencies are in some kind of stagnation. That's it for today, fellas. Let's hope that this scalability issue will be solved very soon, because we all are cryptocurrency enthusiasts, and it will be much beneficial for us if the prices of cryptocurrencies start to rise significantly again. That's it for today. It was me at CryptoSpa, and I wish you a wonderful and productive day.